Hello everyone, I believe you must have watched my Herald Galactus video, and now it's time to get this out of the way as well. Now, I left most of the main gist here for this Thor video, which before I start, you can check the Marvel and DC playlist, subscribe if you're new, and without further ado, let's dive in. In the Galactus video, we established two major things, which was the Yggdrasil dying and the power of the planets Galactus took in. Now, Thor gains the power cosmic, but Galactus thought all this while he gave Thor the power in which Thor took it, and was stated multiple times, which we will see, and that just blatantly shows power cliffing, which is meant to be, as this is King Thor, who has what is called the Thor Force and the Odin Force, in which while Galactus tried not listening to him, he could easily one-shot body parts of Galactus, in which the power cosmic doesn't really change much because but just extends his cosmic awareness. People have a problem with this when Thor literally has always been above Galactus, and I'm talking true Thor. But now it is just worse, as of then a fight would literally happen, but this is just bullying throughout the comics, which is further consistent in power gap, because bitter rebuke has been stated on more than one occasion to rival true Thor, and both their hammers was made and blessed by the Odin Force. But Thor literally flings bitter rebuke to the moon of the newly fed upon and destroyed planet, which is just crazy. Impressive, but Thor tries hyping up the power cosmic as part of the excuse he has for destroying or helping Galactus in feeding on that world, and more to come. And after he powered out of the power cosmic, Bitter got annoyed, and it was blatant that Thor was in full control and did collect the power. Galactus then strikes him with his pride, claiming Thor didn't take his power, but Thor says, "Nay, I took your power, and even Galactus, well armed by a special world, can't even damage Thor at all, as Thor holds him back with no problem." Now, people will say, but bitter rebuke could damage him. Sure, they're both high universal gods in base and wield almost the same strength of weapons, which was used to damage Thor and not bitter rebuke's hand himself. And also know that Thor is keeping his guard down for Bitter massively, which is consistent as one, and armed Galactus is nothing to him and can easily collect his power. 2. He blatantly could destroy Stormbreaker and even cut Bitter Rebuke's hand off while trying to get Mjolnir, but chooses not to, so he then collects Stormbreaker and breaks it, something powerful enough to kill the likes of Fenrir and even exchange hits with Mjolnir in the past. 3. Also note that Mjolnir isn't as strong as it should be, because Thor in this comic is very depressed and was getting unworthy as Mjolnir got or grew heavier. 4. He blatantly decided to kill Bitter Rebuild at the end and did, and Sith interfered. And even at the beginning of the comic, he pulled a feat that seems small, but it is absurd, and even Odin can't do it as stated. He basically threw Mjolnir across the 10 infinite universes, which are all high universal planes, to the point of Asgard, to the point of Midgard, and people don't know that Midgard is actually the entirety of the local multiverse in Marvel, which is high hyperversal, and other realms in Marvel exist within the branches of true Yggdrasil, as I briefly explained in my Galactus video, and I will do so a lot deeper in my cosmology videos coming up. The feat is high universal, and imagine someone with irrelevant speed still moving it transfinitely. That's basically what happened, and it came back so fast in two panels or two pages. That's just striking and throwing strength of Thor as king. And after he tells Galactus he took his power, he did then take it again so they can complete their quest, as they took all these crazy powerful planets as explained in my Galactus video. As they waited for the Black Winter, I would want to answer a question, which is, how do I know this is true, Thor? Simply for the fact that every other universe got destroyed, and the Norse pantheon is actually one of the strongest realms in DC, as well as God of Stories Loki, or 2019 Loki, being in this story just via design as the new iteration of Loki, which was explained in my God of Stories Loki video, which you should check. As Thor battles the Black Winter, he gets taken into the winter, which he was placed under the most realistic illusion I have ever seen. Every opponent's true form Thor has fought, which is more proof of his true form, which includes Gore, Doom, Amora, I don't know why Amora was there, Apocalypse, Juggernaut, Sotor, Mephisto, Mangog, Classic Loki, Yormingander, and Helios, and the Beyonder, or a Beyonder, and they could damage him. And this is impressive to the likes of Black Winter and to Thor, because each of these people are out of versatile to an immeasurably into high out of versatile tier, or means inaccessible. But yet the Winter could summon them in forms of illusion, which they were strong enough to make a hulking Thor use the God Blast by begging Mjolnir. That is sick. If you guys didn't notice, but these are the strongest opponents Thor has fought, even to the point of a Beyonder from the New Avengers run, which are from the Beyond, and the Beyond is arguably above the Outside, which is above True Eternity. Or okay, that's getting there, was just wrong. The Beyond is actually below the Outside, the normal Outside, and it is nothing close to True Eternity, as you guys must have watched. We guys will see who actually, funny enough, True Eternity is in my Never Queen video and Eternity video. Though the True Eternity thing is just based on consistent logic, and I would definitely, with that argument, it is True Eternity. But you know, everybody, most people might not even agree, both Marvel fans. But you know, moving on. And even Loki from Ragnarok, which this Thor is extremely powerful because he does remember other cycles of Ragnarok, including Ragnarok Loki. And if you guys didn't notice, Mjolnir and Huginn are with Thor, which only stays with those who see all and wield powers of the runes, as Thor could even shape the throne from the branches of Yggdrasil, which is sick. Immediately after the Black Winter shows us Galactus' death and the truth behind it, Thor tells Galactus to stand down, as he was still upset about the planets in which he strikes Galactus and rips him off of all his cosmic power. After Galactus tries attacking him, he just BFRs him and takes everything from him and one-shots him. Thor uses the power cosmic, the full power of Galactus, that's insane, with all those planets, plus his own power and the immeasurable power which Galactus held from 100,000 planets, plus those 5, in which a few can make Galactus do crazy shit, plus those special 5, and he creates something far worse than a God Blast. In fact, the God Blast is farther, and yet the God Blast could one-shot all those people, killing the Black Winter with a one shot, and all that was left was a snowflake. He then decides to see his own death, and it is most terrifying. That's the most terrifying thing I have seen in Marvel. Thanos with the deceased revived, which includes Sentry, that's scary, and many crazy people, but worst, Thanos with either Mjolnir or something like it with the Infinity Stones, and something that looks like what Null would use on his left arm, with something possibly could be the new Death Stone, a Death Stone. Now this story is very, very, you know, wonderful. I literally made this video short, and I made the Galactus Zone longer because I was just, you know, being chilled and all in that one. Now this video, you know, with all the videos I've been doing, you know, I really try to put in as much work as I can do and understanding. I try to break it down. The honest truth is that there is no YouTube channel, right? You will go to on YouTube that does what I do. And that's the honest truth, you know. I'm still growing now, so people might not take the channel seriously. I'm still growing, but hopefully, if YouTube is still around for the next 7 years, I know I'll be a top dog by then. Hopefully. And, you know, I just really enjoy what I do, and I really appreciate every one of you who subscribed. If you're new, please subscribe. I know you actually enjoyed this video. If you have questions, always ask. Do not come at me with insults, because if I take it serious and I'm to get in Discord with you, you might not find it funny. Especially if you do not know shit about Marvel and DC, you won't actually find it funny. Now, if you want to debate me, I'm not really like, I don't like VC debates, I don't have strength for echo chambers. So you can always just start debating me in the comments. And you need to know when to concede as well. If you found this video informative, please do to like, comment, subscribe, and turn on post notification, please. And out of all the most, please you guys share it. Please share it. Just share it. Be like, yo, you guys gotta watch this. Share it. And see y'all next time. Peace.